Hello, hi my dear friends. Welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Today we are going to discuss an important topic, that is disorders associated with the digestive system. Okay, let us start. So, see the disorders which are associated with the digestive system, especially the stomach, small intestine, and large intestine. See, what are the disorders which are associated with the stomach? There are peptic ulcer and inflammation. These two are the disorder they are causing stomach. Small intestine. What are the disorders which are associated with the small intestine? See, indigestion is the disorder that is associated with the small intestine. Coming to the large intestine, in the large intestine, constipation and diarrhea. These two are the disorder they are seen in the large intestine. Along with these, the common symptoms of digestive disorders. They include the first one is the vomiting. Second one is the flatus. Third one is the jaundice. These are the disorders what we have to remember: peptic ulcer, inflammation, indigestion, constipation, diarrhea, vomiting, flatus, and jaundice. Let us see each and every one in detail. So, coming to the peptic ulcer. See, peptic ulcer that is associated with the stomach. Actually, the reasons for the peptic ulcer are the excess production of HCl, excess production of HCl, or imbalance between the HCl production and mucus. So, excess production of HCl and low production of the mucus, it causes the ulcers in the peptic region, especially in the stomach. Along with these, there also one more infection, that infection is caused by the H. pylori, Helicobacter pylori. This is the bacteria which is also causing peptic ulcers in the stomach. So, these are the three reasons we have to remember regarding to the peptic ulcer. Coming to the inflammation. Inflammation is a condition where the stomach walls get inflamed. Inflamed, it means the stomach walls become a red and swelling and pain. All these things that will occur are associated with the inflammation. So, this is caused by the excess alcohol consumption and spicy foods intaken. These two regions which are causes the inflammation in the stomach region. Coming to the small intestine, that is the indigestion. We know very well the food must be digested. The food must be digested. If this food cannot digest, that is called as the indigestion. Then what are the reasons which are associated with the indigestion of the food material? First of all, see, the indigestion of food material is caused due to the pancreatitis. Pancreatitis. It means inflammation in the pancreas. Inflammation in the pancreas. So, if the pancreas get inflamed, it cannot produce the enzymes. It cannot produce the digestive enzymes that leads to the undigestion of the food substances. Along with that, there is a duct, pancreatic duct. Pancreatic duct. This pancreatic duct is blocked by the gallstones. If the gallstones that blocks the pancreatic duct, then pancreatic juices that not enter into the duodenum, that cannot act on the digestive substances, especially carbohydrates and proteins and lipids. So due to this reason, the digestion of the food also cannot be expressed. That is called as the indigestion of the food. So this is the condition. And also improper production of bile salts. Bile salts also responsible for the digestion of the lipid moiety. If the bile salts cannot produced by the pancreas and also liver, that also leads to the indigestion of the food. And one more reason is excess intake of food. If you take excess food, that also leads to the indigestion of the food substances. Along with this, pancreatic ulcers. The ulcer which associated with the pancreas, that also leads to the indigestion of the food. Okay, coming to the indigestion, one more reason, that is the improper absorption takes place in small intestine. We know very well small intestine that contains the microvilli. That microvilli is essential for the absorption of the digested food material. If this small intestine get inflamed or get something happened to the small intestine, that will not take any substances into the bloodstream, then also indigestion of the food will take place. So these are the reasons that are associated with the indigestion of the food substances. So coming to the large intestine, actually constipation is a slow movement of the bowel. Slow movement of bowel and low amount of water in the large intestine. Slow movement of bowel and low amount of the water in the large intestine, that leads to the constipation. So due to the low amount, the fecal matter that is becomes a very dry and stores long time in the descending colon due to the slow movement of the bowel. This is leads to the constipation of the digestive system. So what happened? Constipation actually Due to the large intestine infection, if the large intestine contains the infection, that leads to the slow movement of the bowel and excess absorption of the water by the large intestine. So this is the condition constipation will occur. During the constipation, sometimes bowel movement takes place several days, sometimes it also takes place once in a week. So due to the excess storage of the fecal matter in the large intestine, this leads to the mega large intestine. Due to the excess storage of the fecal matter for a week, that leads to the increase in diameter of large intestine 3 to 4 centimeters. That is called as a mega large intestine. So these are the constipation, and these are the reasons for the constipation. Next, coming to the diarrhea. See, diarrhea is a two types. One is a infectious diarrhea. Second one is a psychiatric diarrhea. What happened in the diarrhea? Diarrhea, it means excess loss of water and rapid movement of bowel. These two are the things that are associated with the diarrhea. What are the reason that will occurs for the diarrhea? First of all, let us see the infectious diarrhea. Some bacteria and viruses that are associated with the large intestine, that leads to the, that causes the free movement of the bowel and excess loss of water. That means the large intestine that will not absorb the water that that present in the fecal matter, that leads to the excess loss of water. So these are the two regions that are associated with the diarrhea. Along with the infectious disease, there is also psychiatric diarrhea. We know very well psychiatric diarrhea that associated with the parasympathetic neurons. Sometimes we know very well during the over tension, the diarrhea will occur, especially in the time of exams. So we generally seeing in the time of exams that will occur due to the parasympathetic nervous action. It causes the excess loss of water and rapid movement of the bowel that leads to the psychiatric diarrhea. So diarrhea is associated with the food poisoning. And irritation in the large intestine. Inflammation in the large intestine. So these are the reasons that are associated with the diarrhea. Okay. Next, coming to the common symptoms of the digestive disorder, that is vomiting is a spill out of the stomach contents through the mouth, that is called as a vomiting. Vomiting is caused due to the inflammation or irritation in the stomach, and also inflammation irritation in the duodenum. Along with these two, food poisoning also. Food poisoning also leads to the vomiting sensation. Okay, these are the three reasons which are associated with the vomiting of the food substances from the stomach to the outside of the mouth. Okay, next to the flatus. Flatus is a gases that are produced in the stomach and large intestine. Gases that produced in the stomach and large intestine. Actually, flatus that associated with the swallowing of air. Whenever we swallowing the air, that leads to the flatus, especially swallowing air that contains the nitrogen and oxygen. And also some bacteria which produces the gases that contains the methane, hydrogen and carbon dioxide. These bacteria producing these gases in the large intestine. So, this is the condition, these gases and these gases that are produced in the stomach and large intestine that causes the flatus. So, some food items that also rich source for the bacterial growth, especially that bacteria causes the fermentation during the fermentation that produces the gases like methane, hydrogen and carbon dioxide. What are the food resources that are essential and that are good source for the fermentation of the bacteria? Okay, so see, soya beans, onions, cauliflower and also cabbage, corn and some carbohydrate rich food, apples, etc. These are the food resources that are good resources for the fermentation through the bacteria. That bacteria produce these gases. These gases and along with the swallowing gases leads to the flatus. So finally, jaundice. Jaundice causes by the liver damage due to the liver damage that produces the biles or ingredients into the blood. Due to the jaundice condition, the symptoms which occurs like white part of the white part of eye becomes the yellow. So this is also present or associated with the disorders of the digestive system. Okay, so in this way, all the disorders which are associated with the digestive system, so we have to at least remember what are the disorders associated with the stomach and intestine, small intestine and large intestine, and other things, that is the vomiting, flatus and jaundice. So in this way, all the digestive disorders are present. So I think it is clear to understand. If you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bio Info. Thank you.